probably the greatest natural talent I've ever seen play for Tottenham Hotspur. Please welcome back the great Glenn Hoddle. Listen, as a fan, as a friend, as a Spurs lover, as a man that watched you play, man and boy, I've been looking forward to this day for a very long time. How is it for you?
It's fantastic to be here. It really is. What a stadium. And one, Paul, I'm glad to be here per se. I've got the two guys that kept me alive. I've brought them as guests of the club today. So a very special day for them and for me. Thank you.
When were you aware of, I mean, I know you're a modest man, you're never going to admit to that, but the outpouring of love that was coming to you from all the Spurs fans, well, we mentioned it, the whole of Wembley, you know, sent their love, you could feel it, and when were you aware of it?
Yeah, I mean, my family was telling me what was going on. Obviously, I wasn't in a great shape to know it was all going on, but they were just saying that the outpour of love, as you say, was incredible, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart, I really do. It makes a difference. All the thoughts and the prayers and the love that was sent made a big difference. And it just shows you, you know, what a great club this is.
How special is Tottenham Hotspur to you, Glenn?
Yeah, it's always been special and becomes even more special now, having a bit of extra time, as they say. I've always loved the club since I was 8 years of age. You know, I first came to the Old Lane as an eight-year-old. To a reserve match, and that was it. I was a Spurs fan from those days. And to be able to play for nearly 13 years and manage the club as well, it's been the highlight of my life, really.
I got to ask you, it's always great to hear from players that play for the club and also love the club as a boy. And for someone that did as much as you did, does it truly live up? Because you've done what we all dreamed of doing. Did it truly live up to every expectation you imagined it did when you were an eight-year-old?
Yeah, it did, actually. You know, I've always felt Spurs have played a stylish, creative football ever since the 60s and before the 60s.
Kind of suited you, didn't
it? Yeah, and that's how I wanted to play football. You have to meet fire with fire sometimes, and if you're a creative footballer, somebody wants to take that creation away from you. So you have to show character, you have to have that character to be a footballer in any era. But no, the way that Tottenham played was very important, and we were like a hand in glove, really, the way I played and the way the club, you know, was brought up. And through the 60s, 70s, 80s, it was the way to play.
I think of games that you played in, and believe me, I've seen a lot of them. And one that stands out for me, there's a little game that we've got against a Dutch side, which is on Tuesday. And I remember a European game that you played against a Dutch side, and also someone that played at Ajax, the great Johan Cruyff. I mean, your memories of that game, because that was when we truly saw Hoddle in control.
Yeah, I managed to have a half-decent game there.
Wasn't bad, was it?
Wasn't bad. And playing against Johan Cruyff, who was one of the best players in the world, to do it on that night particularly was very, you know, it was very good. But I think we were 4-0 up at half-time. But let's hope we're 4-0 up at half-time come Tuesday. That's what I'm looking for.
Listen, it's a great run that we're on. You know, it's the furthest in this competition since we go back to the days of the double side of 62. What do you truly, as a Spurs fan and also as a pundit, what do you think of Tottenham at the moment and how far Europe can go?
Well, I think if someone said we're going to be in the semi-final or the Champions League against Ajax, you'd have bitten their hand off. There's no doubt about it at the beginning of the season. But this team at the moment is capable of winning. If you're in the semi-final of a Champions League, you're in with a bloody good chance, and we are in with a good chance. So at the end of the day, we've got the squad to do it. With this support behind, I'm sure there's lots of you going over to Amsterdam and hopefully on the way to Madrid as well for the final.
We were going to ask you for a lift if it was possible.
Yeah, well, I think I'll be working on it, so I'll be there. But can't wait, really. It's a fantastic, almost new history, if you like, for the club. And there's a different vibe, you know, even today, the second half. You guys get behind the team. There's a different vibe with this new stadium. There's a different energy. I really feel that there's going to be some really good years coming round the corner. We've got the greatest stadium in the world, probably. We've got the best training ground, And I think the club will build to get one of the best and strongest squads around. And who knows, it's a good time to be a Spurs fan.
Absolutely. You talk about history, you talk about a great future, and truly from the greatest I ever saw. Please, everybody, the great Glenn Hoddle, and welcome back. It's so great to have you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I love you lots. Thank you.
Thank you, Glenn. Well, if that doesn't inspire us, what will? Get behind the team. Enjoy the second half. And up the Spurs!